Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. How are you? I hope everyone is good. Today I'm going to start with the topic Grade 7 Science about Chapter number 9, which is Physical and Chemical Changes. First, I will give the introduction of the chapter. Matter is something that take up space. Now you might be wondering why they all look so different if they are made up of same thing. But the truth is that everything around you is made up of matter, just in different shapes and forms. Matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms. Matter can be grouped into three states. Number one, solid. Number two, liquid. Number three, gases. To figure out which state of matter something is, we need to examine its properties. A property is the way that something we can measure. Now, what are solids? A solid is something that we can hold on to. A solid keeps its shape unless we cut it or shape it ourselves. In a solid, all the particles are packed together very tightly. Moreover, the solids have a definite shape that don't change when you move it or put it in a container. They also have consistent mass and volume. This is because the atoms of a solid object are packed together, so they do not move around. A solid will change its shape only if forced, for instance, if it is broken or smashed. Now, here are some few examples of solids like helicopter, false teeth, submarine, hammer, saw, clock, etc. Now come towards liquids. Liquids are runny, they can be poured. The particles are less tightly packed, so they can move about. If poured from one container to another, they will take the shape of their new container. Here are some examples of liquids like sink water, soap, milk, juices, beach water, melted snow, fresh water, etc. What is gas? The particles in the gases have lots of room to move. The gases are all around us. They spread into all the empty places they can. Most of the gases are invisible. This is the third state of the gas, which don't have a definite mass, but they do not have a definite shape or a volume. Like liquid, gases take the shape of container. Unlike the liquids, gases will spread out, completely fill the container they are in. If the gas is not in a container, it will keep spreading. This is because the atoms of a gas are farther apart. The atoms, like solid or a liquid, so they can move freely. Now, here are some examples of gases like steam, candle fire, soap, steam, lava, gas smell, evaporation, clouds. The air you breathe is also the example of gas, which is invisible. Now come at page number 104, in which there are some properties of solids, like solids have definite volume, have definite shape, the particles are packed closely, forces between the particles are very strong, have high density, are not easily compressed, expand slightly when heated, and they do not flow. Properties of liquid: have definite volume, match the shape of container, particles are close together, forces between the particles are quite strong, have medium density, are not easily compressed, expand quite a lot when heated, flow easily. Properties of gas: have no definite volume, become the same shape as their container. Particles are far apart. Forces between the particles are very weak, have a low density, expand greatly when heated, flow easily. Now, with the help of some diagrams, there is a comparison between solid, liquid, and gases. This is the diagram number one, showing the comparison of solid, liquid, and gases among their shape, volume, compressibility, or rigidity. This is the diagram number two, which is showing the difference between their size, shape, or volume. Now, in diagram number three, in solid, liquid, and gas, there is the arrangement of particles between them. Now, here is the example of water. Sometimes matter can change from one state to another, so water is the good for it. When water is frozen into ice, it is solid. When it melts back into water, it is liquid. When water evaporates, it becomes a gas. So matter exists in all forms. Come at page number 116 for the relevant questions. And there are two relevant questions, question number one and question number three. Come at question number one, which is, name the only state of matter that can be easily compressed. And the answer is, the gas is the only state of matter that can be easily compressed as the particles are wider apart from one another. And question number three is, which two states of matter flow easily? The two states of matter that can flow easily are liquid and gases, as the particles have enough space to move around. Thank you so much.